information, but also discuss the myths threadbare with them. Now coming to the question of how. How is the information to be imparted? First thing I would like to say is that adolescence is the age when children might rebel against their parents. It is a common experience for us. Try dictating something to a teenage son or daughter and she may retort with a no. She may just say, no, you are not right. Or she may just ignore whatever advice the parents have for the child. Same is the case at schools for teachers. They may not obey their teachers or they may not listen to what their teachers say because this is the age when they rebel. Therefore, there is just no point in teaching and preaching and lecturing. You make them sit in a classroom and then deliver a lecture, it would be of hardly any use to them. They would go out of the classroom and then they would resort to the same behavior which they had before they had attended the lecture. So what could be the way out? How is the information to be imparted? For answering the question to how, I would say that it is always best to engage teenagers in the discussion. It is always better to have an interaction with them so that there is an interactive discourse within the classroom and not a didactic one. When there is a didactic session, the teacher speaks, the adolescents are supposed to be listening. They may not listen, and even if they listen, the information may just not be registered. So it is always better if there is a debate, a discussion, a discourse in true sense, when they have an equal opportunity to speak. Not only speaking with the teacher, but also the classroom environment may be structured in such a way that the students get an opportunity to interact with each other. So group discussions may be there, brainstorming may be there, debates may be there. The main thing is that the children should get an opportunity to express themselves. Then the teachers would also come to know about the kinds of beliefs they have, about the kinds of views they have, and the teacher can get an idea of the point from which she can start. Now, Elizabeth, you may like to add to it.
So here we are discussing about the roles of the teachers. So in instructional purposes, mostly the teachers always frame objectives. So here, selection of learning experiences, it should frame an objective. What is the objective? Is that a perfect health-based education. So what is to be taught and how to be taught? You have listened from Dr. Sutappa that how to give information to the students. And in the method of teaching, this discussion, it is a better thing. But we can see that most of the adolescents who had become addicted, they are suffering from three S factors. The S factors: shame, silence, stigma. Take the case of AIDS affected children. What happened to them? Out of fear, they are not able to reveal the truth to others. So what is happening is that not only affecting themselves, but they are becoming harmful to the society also. So many problems, whatever the students are facing, there should be a free and conducive environment to share with the teachers. So here, among the teachers, I have to tell that they have to shed their inhibitions. And what is the use? And mostly I am concentrating upon this alcohol abuse, and it is leading through. There is a linkage between alcohol abuse and HIV transmission also. And what is the linkage is that the high risk sexual behaviors. And mostly we can see nowadays this adolescence stage, there is that urge for this sexual activity also. So the best thing is that in the instructional roles, the teachers can teach that the abstinence, that is very much important. So prevention is better than cure. So here this abstinence part, how to take place, or otherwise those who cannot control themselves. So what are the ways for the outlet? So here a perfect discussion should be undergone. There should be a fear-free environment in the classroom. So the teacher, he should be a friend, a supporter, all those things should be needed. And here we can see that we can conduct some community involvement programs in the schools also, so that they will get a clear picture about the effects of these social evils. And through this role play and the community participated programs, documentary films, they will get an idea about what are the merits as well as the demerits of being such a, of being involved in such social evil activities. So here we can see these instructional roles. While framing, the teacher should think thoroughly, and there should not be any misconception on the part of the teacher. The vocabulary used by the teacher should be very careful. It should not be heard. It should not transmit wrong knowledge also. And this instructional part, we can see that after entering into some problems, we can hear some echoes of addicts. Some echoes such as, drugs ruled my life, but I didn't even really know it. I was ruining my life with drugs and alcohol, but it was so hard to overcome the temptation. So what is the main role here is that, how to become a person of self-control. I told you about this abstinence. So this self-control, how I can control myself. So what are the effects of if we are not self-controlling? All those things should need a clear understanding. So here the main thing what we are listening is that the teacher's role as a counselor is very much important. So nowadays the teacher is not a sage on the stage, but he is becoming as a counselor. So as a counselor, the teacher should patiently listen to the problems of the adolescents. And mostly in school setup, we can see that the teachers are untrained how to handle this type of students. And more than that, they are overloaded with the syllabus. They are always concentrating upon how to finish the portions. Nobody is there to listen their echoes. So here, a patient listener, a teacher should become a patient listener. And the next one, an empathetic attitude. So some may think that that children belongs to somebody else. Not like that, because they are in our hands. So shaping their attitude, shaping their future is in the hands of the teachers. And the teacher should be a constant supporter. And so many students who are becoming a victim of social evils, they try to detain from the society. In the classroom also, their behavior must be different. So the teacher should be a caretaker to them, a supporter to them. So these things we should be careful while dealing with the children. And now in this aspect, this life skills education is also very much important. So now Dr. Suthappa will give a clear picture on what type of life skills is needed in school situation.
Yes, life skills are definitely important. Life skills are basically the skills that help us in leading a better quality life and also in managing our life in a better way. And not only that, life skills help an individual to utilize his or her potential to the full extent, so that the potential does not remain suppressed, does not go unutilized. And as I said that when adolescents are concerned, or for that matter, not only adolescents, but for even children who are younger than adolescents also, when we try to impart life skills based education, we need to remember that lecturing and other didactic practices will not be very helpful. So we need to think of instructional strategies where or in which the students also get to have a very active role. And besides that, if the teacher at all wants to present something, she may present it in the form of cases. Now, what could be the cases and what kind of cases should the teacher present? First, I would say that the cases should be authentic ones, not something that the teacher has just imagined. This is the difference. This is the primary difference between a case and an example. An example can be thought of instantaneously, but a case is something which is authentic, which has really happened. So the teacher also on the basis of real life experiences, and the teacher may share such cases with the students. The teacher can narrate the cases, or the teacher may get them printed, word processed and printed, and provide the students with a copy and ask them to carry out a reading assignment of such cases. The students would read the cases